Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Welcome your neighbor. Welcome your neighbor properly. Yeah? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Masarembra masarara bokorozika rabara bara 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 bara. Sidamre makarabore bara 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 bara. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Do they feel welcome? Do they feel welcomed? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Give me 1 Corinthians. Eh? 1 Corinthians chapter 16. Eh? Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Chapter 16. Give me from verse 5. Eh? He says, after I go through Macedonia, I will come to you. For I will be going through Macedonia. You wonder why he repeated it. Eh? By the way, do you guys interact with some of these things? Eh? Okay, go down. Eh? It says, perhaps I will stay with you a while. Eh? And everyone got lost. Eh? It says, maybe. Hmm? When you hear a man of God saying these things, eh? So, okay, let us leave that. I'll stay with you a while. Then he gives options. Or even spend the winter so that you can help me on my journey. Pastor Paul, I had a prophecy for him. He's not here. Eh? Perhaps comes in. Eh? So that you can help me on my journey. Eh? Who can help me on my journey here? Okay. Okay, so they're looking like this. this goes beyond contributing. Eh? Yeah? Okay, who can really help me on this journey? Eh? You guys, you have to be sure, eh? Because the Lord is seeing you, eh? And some of you are like, you're trying to be a guy. Okay, we shall get there. So he says, so that you can help me on my journey, wherever I go. Go down. Eh? Then he says, I do not want to see you now and make only a passing visit. Eh? I hope to spend some time with you. So then he says, if the Lord permits. So there's also that possibility. Yeah? Go down. Then he says, but I will stay on at Ephesus until Pentecost. Go down. Eh? Then he says, because a great door for effective work has opened to me. And there are many who oppose me. Give it to me in another version. This particular one, eh? Verse 9. Says, for a great door and effectual is opened unto me. And there are many adversaries. Eh? Adversaries are problems that great door encounters. Eh? Or that great door encounter. So, why we say that actually it's a great door, eh? And actually it is encountered by those many, many what? Adversities and, you know, adversaries, eh? You understand, eh? Yeah? Why it is actually faced with all those things, eh? It's because it's great. You understand that, eh? The devil does not attack small, small doors, eh? Even when some of you think that actually is attacking you, eh? He doesn't. Eh? I'll show it to you somehow. Eh? When it is a great door, he will always do what? Attack it. But you see, a lot of children of God resign and relegate. Sir, I even tried. You see, the first time I went there in that fellowship, the devil attacked me. I almost got an accident. But praise the Lord. Do you realize that also at some point, when a great door has actually been opened unto you concerning, let's say, healing, the devil can attack you more with sickness and disease. When a great door is actually open unto you, let's say for finances, I'm telling you, you are sacked and all that and all those things. Now those are things that children of God really encounter. You understand? You know, to the world out there, they commit suicide. But you know, this great door, a great door, he calls it a great door. Tell your neighbor that I'm a great door. And some of you say, are you sure? I'll show you how. I'm telling you, the moment you came here, or every Friday you come here, you cease to be just mere doors. You become a great door. But also a door people enter. You first even live around the great door. But any door people do what? But also some can be closed out. You understand? For a great door and effectual. It is effective. You guys, do you know how effective you are? Do you know how effective you are? Maybe you haven't yet known it. You see, you are effective by the dictates of education, which is a lie. Education can only build a house somewhere and give you a car, a simple car, Toyota. Okay. Some of you go and say, God, if you give me a Vitz, I'll be grateful. Education can only give you a measure of success here and there. You understand? How did it become to be a great door? There was a day the Lord ministered unto you the first gospel words. He said, have dominion. Have what? On that day, you became a great door. But you see, that was actually through conceiving. Again, it comes back. Perceiving and conceiving on the inside of you. Let me also remind you, that great door, all of you touch your bellies. Some of you are touching there as if it's not there. Say, this is my great door. And I'll show you how. You see? That belly you've touched, called the heart. The heart is not here. Your belly is your heart. Have you ever been chucked? You feel the pain here? Or you feel you are actually, you feel unfairly treated? You feel the pain here? You guys, Now, some of you develop even headaches, whatever. Now, those headaches, they spring from the heart. Because, do you know why? Because the heart is the most genuine place. You can actually draw transactions there. Anything there. You feel bad, see ya. You understand? Do you know also you can lock and unlock doors from here? Locking and unlocking doors. Now we are talking spiritual things. Some of you wonder how even to pray in the Holy Ghost. How to capture these things by the Holy Ghost. It is actually as simple as that. You understand? Eh? Let me also remind you something. Eh? Do you remember Jacob? Eh? Jacob? Eh? Eh? Not Job. Jacob. When a blessing was passed on to him. Eh? Eh? Okay, let's. Okay, there were those two boys. Eh? Esau and who? Jacob. Eh? Hmm? Okay, Esau. There's also Pharaoh. Eh? Pharaoh. See? You understand? Eh? Whatever Esau had been given, he had not been given a land title. Nope. The inheritance was by impartation. And he conceived it on the inside of him. Okay, if I'm hurrying, you say, eh? Simama apo kwanza. Is it? What I'm teaching you, what I'm imparting on unto us, will also shall also help you to pray in other in the spirit. Eh? By the aid of speaking in other tongues. You know, some of you, when we tell you pray in other tongues, eh, you see, because actually you've actually read certain things, I say, what? No, other tongues are not for everyone. They are for everyone. Eh? Actually, he desired that all of you may actually speak in other tongues, eh, because it's an aid to reach the realm of God. I repeat, it's an aid to reach where God is. God has a realm where he lives. Eh? Yeah, that's actually, we repeat most of these things. God is everywhere, but actually you cannot see him and you cannot meet with him everywhere. You can meet him by the aid of your bosom, of your belly. How did your father Abraham become the father of all? Belly. You have all the millions here. Before now, God sets you out there. Sets you upon a rock, not sinking sand. Eh? Meaning actually, he will actually bring men and women around you. Eh? Who will actually aid you. Some of you do not know why actually that neighbor is actually seated next to you. You simply don't know. In a vulgar way, we mistreat them. So you go. You understand? Eh? Because actually all you see is a person putting on glasses and that's it. Eh? Did you know that actually some of them are actually potential business people, eh? Partners? Eh? Did you know that? Eh? Now let's go back. This great door, again. Do you remember? Now let's go back to Jacob again. When the Lord now when Isaac, actually this guy stole something by the leading of the Holy Ghost. Eh? Okay. So he's encouraging us to steal. There are actually people that God actually, you see, in that day, it was actually the aid of a mother. Though some mothers are fake today. I'm telling you the truth. You hear me? Fake. By the way, I'm not even, you know, fake. Also some fathers. Eh? If not many. Eh? See, eh? So here we see a transaction happening. Yeah. How does it even happen? Eh? You know, this guy actually goes, you know, and finds out, you know, wild meat and all those things. Now, all those are to aid you to reach that goal. Eh? You understand? Eh? So, then the meat is brought and, you know, you all know what really happened. And this guy, somehow, he runs away with a blessing. Did you see Esau saying, bring back my land titles! Bring back my land titles! Did he say that? What does even scripture say? What did he actually run away with? What did he even run away with clothes? So what did he run away with? And where, you know, did he carry it? Stop, what? This thing is heavy. Or Esau reached somewhere and said, you know, I know you are carrying things and you know you get tired. Eh? You understand? Eh? A great door was opened unto him and he accepted it. He embraced it on the inside of him. This door, like I said, this great door, is on the inside of you. There are greater doors that come, let's say through promotion, and maybe through being planted here and there. But Kwanza, you have to perceive it and conceive it, because to so many of us, great doors have been actually opened unto us, but actually they've been hindered. Let's say, I have so many examples. Let's say it's a job opening. Now, first things actually, do I have a degree? You see there? Those are hindrances. And for as long as you accept those things on the inside of you. Okay, let's go back to, let me use an example that people understand. A guy interested in a what? In a girl. Look at her. They will look at her, look at her, look at her. But am I the one for her? You understand? How does that woman perceive that actually you are the one? Because at some point, actually, they are very, very good conductor, you know, conductors of the Spirit of God. Let me tell you, she will perceive, she will conceive it that, this guy here. Yet actually, on the outside, we are seeing the, you know, this guy having all the qualities, but somehow, the guy is actually dumped. Makes sense now? Guy driving, or other, you know what most of you actually, you know, are attracted to, and attracted by, On the outside, we are seeing this guy having all these, you know, qualities. But one woman, and actually you see those guys going, but please come back, what? Somehow, this woman is hindered by certain things that she has actually conceived on the inside. And later on, she will actually be right and true. You will see. You understand? Now also, do you remember, you know, the day Adam fell? The day Adam fell, you're no longer that old Adam. You are a new Adam in Jesus. You understand? My style also said that this great door is actually Christ on the inside of you. But you can as well make this Christ dormant. Very, very dormant. And actually now you just move. I'm also born again. But now the qualities. You know, you are just say what? You know that signpost. But actually, no movement at all. So, on that day when Adam fell, there was an exchange that took place. We call it beauty for ashes. You understand? Adam exchanged his authority to nothing. But actually, it was through deception again. How does someone get deceived? And actually, you see, they enter the deception thing. How do they? Belly, bosom, heart. Okay. First again that I have dominion on the inside of me. Where is your inside? It is here. I'm telling you people, the day actually practically you'll actually find out. You realize that you can lock and unlock a lot of things. How many of us have ever experienced joy? Yeah? Joy. Joy unspeakable. Eh? Not when you have money. Eh? Money can give you happiness. Eh? Today, see, I say, when someone doesn't have money, is he? Eh? No, that joy beyond money is cultivated on the inside of you. I'm telling you, people. Eh? But also, it takes some time. Some of you think that the devil just deceived Adam for one day, or within one day, or within hours. Nope. It took him some time to strategize to whatever. I'm telling you. Until now, boop, you know, he was actually caught. Eh? And, you know, put in a cage. All he could see was actually through a cage. He was actually admiring all these things, but actually he couldn't get out. That which happened, actually, was transferred on the inside of him. All of a sudden, he started actually feeling the fear. He's seeing a great door, but actually fear gripped him. Eh? Let me also remind you. You remember Job? He said that, you know, he says that, you know, what does he say? The life I feared the most, says the most, it has caught up with me. Where did he, where did he get that fear from? Eh? There was a certain life he feared, the life of lacking. Yeah? The life of I don't have money. But before he had the money, right? Yeah? Because you see, okay, let me also tease some of, some of you, eh? Yeah? Some of you might actually go, I might actually remain with a few congregants. Eh? Okay. Eh? I got it from a certain wise man. Eh? Hmm? Do you know Job existed actually before Abraham? Eh? Okay. Who is this guy? Let me step away. Because he might. Do you read the Bible? Most of you read it, yeah? Chronological way. And then Adam, and then after Adam, then Eve, what? Then there's what? Esau, then, like that. Eh? If you saw the wealth that Job had, eh? My God. You can't even compare it to today. I'm telling you. But while he was actually living that life, the mistake he did was actually now to bring in another affair on the inside of him. You understand? Eh? The affair of fearing to lose. Every time you would actually think about that, you'd be like, I wonder how it will be when I don't have the money. Started singing such songs. Eh? And then such songs caught up with him. You know actually how you can actually be there and say, I wonder how, now let us now translate it to girlfriend, boyfriend. Eh? Okay, help me, how 1, 2, 3, go. Okay, I'm joking. You see? All guys relating, bowed down the heads in adoration. It can actually be, let's say, a guy who's actually supplying you. Then, all of a sudden, you start actually thinking, how will it be without this guy? You see, when those guys go, when those people go, you see now people quaking. They in fear all of a sudden. Eh? For you, prophet, you are just there talking. Do you know what this man has been giving me? Now those such conversations start. Eh? Yeah? Maybe if you are sick, because actually it's a two-way traffic. Eh? Yeah? Flip that coin. Eh? It has actually another side. If you are sick, you say, man, I wonder how it will be when I'm completely what? Healed. You see now, then you start planning like that. You understand? That life lives on the inside of you. Today, let me actually emphasize it. Today, I wonder how it will be when I'm sacked. What? Now you see, you start actually to work on tiptoes. You actually mess it up. I'm telling you, it can actually be a profession. It can be anything. Even music and singing and all that. You fear to mess it up. Because you have actually welcomed in another life which is actually alien, which was actually alien before. Adam didn't know that life of lack and what and running up and about. There was a day when that great door was actually opened unto Adam, which is now you, right now through Jesus. When it was actually opened up to him, He didn't have to search for a job. I pray you become that translated Adam, that actually now jobs spring from you. Jobs spring from you. Okay. I've just banished that thing called what? Job seeking in pain. While you are seeking for that job, there was a great door and effectual. The Lord saw how effective you would actually be. He said, now have dominion. He would have given it to Simba. Well, it's king of the jungle. You are not living in the jungle. You see, But also, in relation to that, think about it. Where do you get the fear of a lion? Let me give you an example here. Two examples from a certain wise man I know. And I've actually given you this example before. Someday, he was actually praying. Those many, many years ago, praying up on a hill. You would actually leave very, very early, let's say 5 or 6 a.m. Starting from, let's say, as early as 7 p.m. until, the Lord instructed him to go there. For you, if the Lord has not instructed you to go there, But of course, some of you have actually made it religion, I'm going to the mountain. You come back as skinny as what? You can't scare anyone. Okay. So, he comes back early in the morning to do what? He's going back home, and to his house. And then dogs. They call it what? Mumbwa. In Greek, it's called mbwa. Okay, let's say a multitude of heavenly dogs worshipping. I don't know whether they were heavenly, earthly. You see? Now they face each other. You see? There's a guy actually. Let me leave that. on one of those tours, we used to travel. A big dog came. And this guy actually, there was a tree in the compound, like a small tree in the compound. He hid there. True story, I know the guy. So this guy actually feared the dog to that extent. He was a big man. You see, But you see, listen now, to the combination of it. So you see, the first time he's fearing dogs. So they came actually chasing after him. And indeed he took off. You understand? Because actually now you've actually given those dogs liberty. You understand? Eh? But as he continued in the spirit, praying in the Holy Ghost, actually said, today, I know their path. They always congregate there. Eh? This time around, he came. He came. Because there was some, and actually he's not coming with what? With swords and what? Eh? Today they attach me, stones what? Especially now, when they are stubborn dogs, eh? You touch down and you see. I've done that several, eh? I'll not tell you the stories. Eh? Those days, eh? No, of course, not today. So, you see, eh? So, this time around, he says that he now approached them. He says, now, you see, eh? Do you know what they are picking on before? Do you know what they were picking on before? What you've actually conceived on the inside, fear on the inside of you. I am telling you the truth. You can use this trick. Yeah? Yeah? Recently, actually, I gave it to a certain lady in Uganda there. Hmm? That Greek land. Eh? Boss is disturbing me. What are those things? Whatever. They even actually threatening to do what? I think I told her. To sack me. They've actually given me just this month. Yeah? And I said, why are you fearing? You see, yeah? Now, somehow, she built her faith on the inside. She wrote to me jubilating. Can you imagine? The boss went mute about it. You can use this trick. I'm telling you. But of course, we are telling you, okay, you know, we are not telling you to do what? Sit back and say, I know how to construct you. What you need to do, you do, eh? You see, eh? Don't be a lazy chap, eh? You understand, eh? So, remember when he went to Asia at some point? Eh? Eh? And then, there was actually, you know, it was a cave. And in that cave, they said that a few people have actually survived. But actually, they made it so much interesting that, you know, on the other side, it looks like heaven. They even show you pictures and all that. So, prophet actually got interested. He said, man, let me what? I want to reach that side. Man, this place looks so what? Beautiful. But down there were many, many snakes. Eh? Yeah? Both sharp and what? You know, eh? Sharp to mean venomous. Eh? You see, eh? So he had actually traveled with a guy. Eh? They are moving with his driver. Eh? Yeah? And the guy said, are you sure you want it? So, prophet actually puts on a certain life on the inside of him. Eh? Hmm? He's not actually wearing jackets and all that. Eh? Yeah? And passing there running. So that actually some snakes miss him. Eh? You know, eh? And you all know Asia. I've actually been there as well. It's hot. Eh? Ah, putting on a jacket. Man, you can be in a sauna, really. So, he started to move. He moved. But actually, he was feeling, eh? The tongues of the what? Of those snakes. Eh? You know? I'm telling you, on his body. He was actually, they are really not biting him. Eh? You see, eh? Because you see also those snakes, eh? Are attracted by the fear. That fear you build on this. I'm telling you people, I wish you get to know this. Eh? Hmm? Until at some point actually I told someone, eh? Eh? For you everything that bangs, bah! The neighbors are, you are trying to, you were actually so much triggered to fear. Eh? I want to see what's happening. Eh? You understand? Eh? On the inside of you, there is both life and death. Eh? You can choose to trigger. And each one you trigger, let me tell you, it will be life. You realize why you are praying and things actually are not moving. Eh? Yeah? So back to our story. Eh? He continued. But now this guy, he had actually moved into, you know, inside with. Eh? Yeah? Suddenly now shouting. Eh? Ah, what? He actually stopped somewhere. maybe in the middle. I say, eh, for the sake of this guy. Eh? But actually, in there, he said that I triggered myself to the faith, and now that faith that actually I put on the inside of me, yeah, made me go and go and go and go and go and go. He says that I could feel. He says that actually he could feel his what? Their what? Their tongues and all that. But actually there was, they couldn't go beyond that. I am telling you, you see how you give the devil liberty? Be careful on what you are meditating about and on. Let the words of my mouth, meditations of my heart, be acceptable. At some point, what you're meditating upon, yeah, and what your heart is really conceiving and all that, yeah, totally two different things. No wonder we actually utter out words which are actually not in line. They are not one. People actually start confessing certain things. Eh? But actually, when you look at it very, very, very well, eh, your heart has actually conceived and perceived certain things from afar. And actually, that heart starts actually to welcome them. Not my words. It says, yeah, that now those men, okay, says that, and your father Abraham saw my day and he rejoiced. It is there. Abraham saw this day, the day of technology, eh? The day of grace. I'm telling you, a day of Jesus. Eh? This is the day that the Lord has made. The Lord made this day. Jesus made this day. It's up to you either to be gloomy in it or to rejoice in it. All this life you carry, you understand? Eh? Remember when he said that before you I place life and death? Eh? But actually he says, but choose life. What does that mean? You cannot meditate upon anything deathly and deadly. Man, in a twinkly, you'll actually fall. Eh? Yeah? He says, I saw the devil fall like lightning. When you flip it like this as well, eh, you can fall off in a twinkling. Poop! A person that has actually been rejoicing and whatever, expectant and all that, and then, doop. Actually, to some of you, normally I joke around it, this is Friday. Eh? To some of you, actually, it doesn't even take, a whole weekend before you fall. Eh? Before you fall, in Revelation. Eh? Apo! Now we actually start hearing a guy, do you know what we are going through? You. You can erase or plant anything on the inside of you. Life. That great door, most of you have actually been looking for it. Eh? It's actually on the inside of you. Eh? A great door. Yeah? You see, eh? of course, to some people, they start to think about the Lord, yeah? On Thursday, because now the following day is what? Friday. Tomorrow is Friday. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, there, eh? You go visit them, eh? And you see what they will actually be talking and, confessing. Eh? You see, eh? And the devil targets that. Eh? Do you remember when the enemy showed Jesus a city and kingdoms? Do you remember? Do you remember? Of course, the Jesus movie, yeah? That's not the one, eh? That most of you have actually watched, eh? You remember the first one? Yeah? That guy, I think, still lives, eh? Who actually acted like Jesus, eh? Yeah? I have an instruction. I hope I. So, even Passion of Christ, eh? they tried a bit to portray what that man went through. You know, most of you think that actually that's it. Remember, it's a movie. But there was a day when actually it happened originally and for real. Some of you, they just point at you. Prophet, these are things I don't like. Now, people don't like me. You know, Now, what if they worked you, You know, some of you stop at the kibokos, stripes. The man was beaten. You see, You guys, Even actually that which they did in the movie, I remember actually a documentary that was actually shown. The guy actually who did Passion of Christ as Jesus. After that, actually he was taken for some surgery. Because some kibokos actually entered him. I'm telling you, the documentary is there. Not my words. I dug deep. I said, hey, man. Some of you just... You, tomorrow, tutaonana, tutapatana. And then you lose it. You see, in a Kenyan accent. Mine was what? Greek. Okay, mine was heavenly. You see, And on the other side, Mimi. You see, you can scare off anything, but also not merely scaring off things here and there. Today you have money, tomorrow you don't have. You can build an empire on the inside of you, which is actually unshaken. All the time, I'm telling you the truth. Do you know, the devil can actually attack the flesh, but actually, he cannot penetrate through the spirit. That spirit is actually what we are imparting on the inside of you. I pray you start actually engaging some of these things. Just like actually most of the times I tell you that, you see, let's say you lack 1,000. Construct it and don't be in a hurry. Don't actually say, God, now. God, for me. There you've actually missed it. Go pole. You reach there. But actually, you need to learn how to construct it. I'm telling you, people. Okay, let me give you an example. How do you know that food is good? And the chorus answers always, by tasting it. How do you know that food is good? Do you know it all comes back here? Not actually when it has actually entered. No. Because you think through here. You made it everything, I'm telling you people. Some of you think as you use your brain. That brain. In heaven, there's nothing called brain. When you sit out to become actually heavenly, I'm telling you people, you suspend what we call the brain. You understand that? Do you remember when the Lord said that, they were actually trying to give him food, those guys, when he was actually talking to the Samaritan babe? So he said, I have another food. And that food was sweeter than what they had actually what? You understand? You see? Do you know you can enter a certain restaurant? Okay, any place. And then you feel... I remember when we were actually flying to Brazil. We're actually in the air. You know? I told my leader that, man, I sense something, which actually I told him. I'll not mention it. And then the guy said, ah, you wait till we land. After like 2 weeks into Brazil, he confessed what you saw is true. You understand? Some of you actually who fly, you will actually, I said some of you, Okay. Many of you who start flying. But you see, this comes by conceiving. Let me relate it to what I actually, what I explained, last week. Also the other week. The bus is an option, but also flying is an option. One reaches faster than the other. One is more comfortable than the other. You reach somewhere after the bus, you are stretching the back, you mad, what? But also, by flying, there is also economy and what? But what's wrong with you? We're all going to the same destiny. Like having a cavits and a default. No, we are moving from thicker and what? Tao. Comfort matters as well. You know, when you start to speak that language, some people, think it's just, pride and all that. Mm-mm. See now, until you conceive that now, I am now ready for flying. You'll just be. It will actually just be in the mind, wishful. I wish. You understand? But a day you get a grip of it like this, in the spirit, like this, you will not actually know where those tickets have actually come from, somehow. But then some of you are working. Prepare to fly. They are actually specific, working. I'm telling you, those of you that have actually never even tested the caplane, you see, You see, You will see the difference, You see, You see, conceive. Now, Jesus at some point, Jesus encounters the devil. And then there was a, there was a conversation and all that. So the devil tells him that if you bow down and worship me, what does he say? I'll give you these things, all these kingdoms you see. How did the devil get those things? But also question is, who gave him those things? By now we know that actually it's Adam. There was an exchange. He gave out literally his dominion. That dominion was somehow, I'm telling you. Do you know you can start governing a whole country by this? We do that a lot. Some of you, we shall never tell you how certain things actually are diverted and what, and they go. But also what we do, Some of you might actually never know how you are expecting a bad report from what? I remember someone, I think they are seated right the other side. I gave them a prophecy concerning work, their workplace. Man, and the thing got so ugly. I remember we were traveling. This person knows themselves. We're traveling somewhere. It was, I think, the three of us or some. And also another lady. Somewhere. So, prophet for you, do you know? Things have got so ugly. And I told them, but remember the prophecy I told you that it will actually go away indefinitely. How those things actually just ended like that, they don't even know. Before the Jesus thing, do you remember Elijah, the prophet? He stops the rain. How did he stop it? Do you guys, do you realize how a great door you carry? You just need a little bit of taking it a notch higher concerning all things. You realize how a king you have actually been, but also how you've actually been depriving yourself of a certain higher life. There's actually such a higher life like that. Bosom. How did Elijah stop the rain? But also, how did he bring it into existence? Elijah. Some of you are going to say, he prayed and fasted. He prayed so much. Yes, he prayed. But also, how did he pray? You guys get it? Some of you are going to say, yeah, he put his word. He said, what? That was actually to show you how serious it went. But actually, much of it, the rumblings, actually, they were here. I am telling you. Have you ever been so scared about, you know, certain things? Let's say workplace. And then you are scared. Maybe you are scared you're going to lose the job and all that. Where do you feel that thing? Where do you feel it? Some of you also will reach you and actually we want, you know, to prophesy to you. Like how we want to do today. But actually, do you know what we feel? The moment I pick that fear, you know, fear, from here, I don't go deeper there. We can't, because then you've actually resisted us. We feel a hindrance. I'm telling you the truth. Some people actually, even one-on-one, you meet them and actually you feel a resistance. You see a brighter future. You see all these things about them. But actually somehow, they've actually been deceived on the inside of them. They see the thing, they want it, they desire it, but actually they are hindered. Somehow, they drop. You see, a priest has actually got drunk. Now that, you know, that getting drunk. Here, I'm telling you. So Elijah, he senses that now it's time for what? For rain. And he was responsible for bringing back that rain. Now it's time. So he goes somewhere. Then, you know, he starts to pray in the Holy Ghost. There were certain shiftings he had to do in the spirit. You will actually feel it. At some point, actually, you feel a wailing. You want to wail on the inside of you. You understand? That's why, I think, I told some people, that's actually why some of these sitting room prayers don't help. Don't help some of us. Let me give you an example. Remember the man of God, prophet, last Tuesday, sobbing in the pillows and all that. He could not do that somewhere. But actually, remember, he said, hotel room. There's a certain liberty. I know that liberty. I know it very well. Boss has, that thing has actually gone indefinitely. Sitting room prayers. That's actually how fight can actually go. But also, somehow we know how to trigger ourselves. Now I'm not saying that stop praying in the sitting room. You know, some of you misinterpret some of these things. Pray, but actually there's a time when you feel you want to shift certain things. Let me tell you, you go over and above. You understand? I can give you examples now. Go, you know, let's go back to Jesus. This guy shows him that these things I'll actually give you if you bow down, meaning if you agree to my systems. Must I also say that when you fail that day, somehow practically, in a sense, he got all your treasures and actually he shut them somewhere. So to say, think about it like that. Such that actually if you want them, There are great things, which actually he calls what? A great door. There are great things, but actually hidden somewhere. Not hidden, locked up somewhere. But also remember when actually when he rose up, he says, I've given you the keys. You understand, eh? You can unlock anything. People, I am telling you my life. Eh? Do you know you can unlock cars? Eh? A car that you want. Eh? Eh? Not someone actually desires for you. Eh? I think at the look of things, let us start with what? Eh? Mitsubishi. There's like a small one there. Eh? Then actually you start putting things, fuel consumption. Let me tell you. You are really getting your life. Eh? When you start calculating those things, feel what? No, they say what? They say what they say it. Eh? Eh? So you feel what? Eh? You know, eh? And then you start, yeah, it doesn't actually take. What if actually you go into Nyeri? 2 hours. You put 1K and you see. You are there just bragging around your guys around Tao, eh? Oh, what? You go to Nyeri and put 1K. See whether you go and come back. See, no man, talk there. Eh? You tell us where. There's a prophet. We need prayers here. Say, hey, what's wrong? Is it? Oh, the prophet, prophesy now. The bones coming back to life. Eh? Son of man. Is it? So it reached a point where this guy, the devil, he's trying to give Jesus. Thank God, you know, for discernment. Thank God for the Spirit of God. Eh? You know, eh? Jesus looks into, and actually, some of you cannot discern. So you think actually you can pull it off like Jesus. Eh? Jesus actually just looked at it like this, but he knew already where this was actually headed. Eh? You know, eh? Some of you might not have the faith which actually sees so quickly like that. Eh? But actually you can build yourself unto that. Eh? I'm telling you, it is the most beautiful life ever. Most beautiful. You can see into your tomorrow, eh? Without any doubt. I'm telling you, anyone here has a way to enter there. You understand, eh? To some of us, man, it can begin with worship and all that. But also at some point, I trigger it. Boop, now I want to see certain things, eh? Now I'm not teaching us, yeah? I'm not telling us to be demon conscious, eh? Okay. I was going to say certain story, but let me not say it. You know, some people actually here are so much attached to demons. Eh? You get so obsessed about demons and demon chasing and all that. Eh? Eh? You understand? Eh? I was telling someone, eh? Man, there are certain things actually I enjoy. Eh? Some of them are birds. Eh? Flying birds. Eh? How do you call them in Kiswahili? Ndege. Mandege, ndege. You, are you? Okay, we understand you are heavenly. You don't know these things. You don't know this language. Eh? Yeah, we understand. Eh? How do you call birds? Eh? Eh, now, what's the difference between the others? Oh, because they fly, eh? Okay. So, I love watching them, and you see, at our place there, they come early in the morning expecting some food. Eh? Some guys, you can be so much demon conscious. I say, demons are monitoring me. See. They always come monitoring me. I'm telling you. It actually, the Lord wants you to enjoy the beauty. You see, eh? Okay, ndege. Why don't you say the same thing with aeroplanes? You know, you can miss it. I'm telling you. And it's so easy to talk that language. I'm telling you. And then you miss the life of God. Actually, while you are actually so much obsessed about demon what? Eh? Monitors. Eh? You know, eh? In that way, there is a life which is actually being constructed for you. But also, on the other side, well, if you escape it and actually jump out of it, okay, start like, you know, man, eh? You see, start actually enjoying life. Eh? Having a good perspective of life. You understand? Eh? With all your prospects, try to actually squeeze them into one jar of called, you know which is called the Zoe, life of God. And say now, my health is like this. Put it there. Some things actually you put, others actually are still pending outside. Eh? They're actually on the peripherals. Eh? Don't. Eh? Now my money, I'm telling you, before you know it, you realize actually that all life has actually been put in one jar called the Zoe, the life of God. You'll actually see your health actually catching that. I'm telling you. Your movements, people will actually just say, how were you even able to escape that accident? How are you even able to get that job? I'm telling you, everything, you try it out. Eh? But also, this I'm telling you, it's not a one-time thing. It can take you certain good months and years constructing. Until now, you say, aha, now. You remember a guy who said, the Lord is my shepherd, and I have everything I need. I'm telling you, he looked around, and actually was surrounded by everything actually he wanted. Eh? Even with human resource, eh, you realize that, this one I can, yeah, okay. I'm telling you, it happens just like that. The Lord is actually my shepherd. I have all these things I need. And I he knew that actually I have all these things. Not I will get all these things that I need. No. He looked around and said, yeah, this is actually now the life. This is actually the life. Until Prophet Elvis said, everything has actually been what? Put in that word, the life of God, which is the Zoe. Yeah? Except Asno. Eh? That one is still pending. Eh? Manu, again, I don't know. I looked. The door was closed. I said, maybe bring an offertory. Eh? So. I'm joking. And then we pray, placing our hands and feet, is it? Because we are the hands and the feet of Jesus. I'm joking. You see, huh? But also at some point, prophecy has to come to pass. Eh? I told you 2 years. Eh? Why do you want? Eh? Now let your heart relax about certain things. Eh? Man, eh? And you see a guy, betting even. Man, you become a laughing stock there. Eh? You didn't trust the word of the prophet. Eh? And all the signs are showing you. Eh? Of course, man, I watch. But also, man, the best thing is actually, so I stopped also seeing, concerning those, because actually the best game is actually when you're not seeing anything. You just want to enjoy. Yeah? So then actually it won't be a surprise. Eh? So an exchange happened at some point. And then the devil took exactly what you had conceived here. He tricked you. Don't allow that. Eh? You understand? Eh? Then, somehow, he ran away with it. You remember where we started from? Jacob. Eh? He took off. Jacob didn't run with a bag. Just like actually in cartoons, how it's actually, you know, portrayed. Eh? With a stick running. No, the guy took off. Eh? Because remember, actually, he had to take off in haste. Yeah? Because actually, Esau, that guy Esau, if I see you like this, because he reached out the curtain. But also remember how it was actually transferred from Isaac unto the boy. Remember the words he said. He didn't say, call your mother Becky. Also to give you some land titles. Because remember the Becky girl is actually the one that played for him the Kadati game there. Though it was actually of the Lord. You know some of you are weird. You think actually that the devil. The devil was not in it at all. Some guy, the Lord had actually handed him, just like we are about to say certain things to you. So we hand you these things by impartation, and then people start to look around. But for you, prophet, practically, do you think this can? Now I go beyond those practical things. Practically, certain things have been brewed already. Practically. So I want you to walk in already done deal. You understand? But again, it starts with conceiving. This is one full month we're talking about conceiving. But if you don't understand it, I'm telling you, heaven is your hope. By the way, you'll actually understand what conceiving is. You can, let me say this, you can manipulate your life through here. Manipulate life around you. You can play around with guys around there by this. You can unlock that tap or lock it up. You yourself have the power to make it either roll or remain stagnant somewhere. Please don't cry. Let me tell you, but also how do you actually ignite it? First of all, actually, you start praying by those sensations. You actually feel those sensations. Just like actually you can actually think about someone and actually you actually have those bad sensations. It has happened to everyone.